Good evening, students. Today we have to discuss one of the important equipment, that is transformer. Transformer is a static electric device which transfers the electrical power from one circuit to another circuit with same frequency. It can change the voltage level from one circuit to another circuit, respective variation of current. Indian generation of AC voltage is designed for 50 Hz. Hence, this voltage remains from generation to up to consumer point. While transferring the power from generation to consumers, we are having different types of transformers are coming in picture. But frequency remains same. Okay, it works on the principle of Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. That means whenever a conductor cuts a magnetic flux, an EMF is induced. This is Faraday's laws. Once again, whenever a conductor cuts the flux, or whenever a conductor links a changing flux, an EMF is induced. Basically, it consists three parts as shown in figure. Magnetic core, it is made of thin laminations to reduce the eddy current losses. Core consists two vertical parts, those are referred as limbs. It consists limbs, two limbs. Each limb consists one winding. One winding is referred as primary winding and another winding is referred as secondary winding. Primary winding has n number of turns. Similarly, secondary winding has n2 number of turns. Primary means that is input. Which side the input voltage is applied, AC voltage is applied, that side is referred as primary winding. And which side the load is connected, that is taken as secondary side. Okay. We are applying AC input voltage, which causes the flow of AC current. This AC current in primary winding result of alternating flux in the core, which results the production of alternating flux. This flux changes from 0 to 360 degree in one cycle. Its magnitude goes on changing. This changing flux links n1 turns of the winding. Hence, an EMF is induced. This EMF is referred as self-induced EMF. Similarly, the same changing flux also links to the secondary winding, n2 turns of winding. Hence, there is a existence of rate of change of flux. Hence, a EMF is induced. This induced EMF is referred as mutually induced EMF. Hence, the voltage is available at secondary side. Voltage is available, E2. If the load is connected, circuit is closed, then secondary current will flow. Hence, in this manner, electrical AC power is transferred from one circuit to another circuit by mutual induction principle. The same thing, self-induced EMF across primary winding is E1, E1 equal to d phi by dt. Where n1 is number of turns of primary winding, d phi by dt. Hence, rate of change of flux linkage, that means flux linking with the conductor should change. If it remains constant value, then no induced EMF, because no d phi by dt. As the time changes, flux should also change. Hence, it is called changing flux. Similarly, the changing flux also exists across secondary winding, n2 turns. Hence, P2 gives secondary induced EMF. This is called mutually induced EMF. This is induced due to current of coil number 1. You remember 3 points. Transformer is a static device. It transfers the electrical power from one circuit to another circuit with same frequency. It works on Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction or mutual induction. The transformer ratio, another important factor, K, it is defined as the ratio of secondary turns to primary turns or secondary voltage to primary voltage. As per the turns ratio, we are having two types of transformers, step up, step down. Step up means voltage should be increased. That means we have seen in power plant generation unit, 11 kV voltage is generated and it is raised to 11 kV, 220 kV. Such type of transformer is referred as step up. Step down, voltage level should be reduced primary to secondary. That means step down transformer. First one transformer we may observe in generation unit. Second one transformer, it may be used in house applications. Step down transformer, where we are taking the connection from the pole, that is secondary of transformer, 230 volts. Input is 11 kV. 11 kV line, 240 volt. This is step down transformer. Now you can observe very clearly how the laminated core is used. This is a type of steel structure, laminated core. Laminated, instead of one core material, the thin laminated structures are to be arranged to form a core, because it reduces the heating effect or it reduces the eddy current loss. Now you can practically observe which one is step up, which one is step down transformers. Now you can see the primary first diagram, step up transformer. This is coil, primary coil, 1, 2, 3, 4. Number of turns of the primary is 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Number of turns on secondary is 6. Hence, N2 is greater, N1 is smaller. N2 is greater, N1 is smaller. Such type of transformer is referred as step up. Now, step down. Step down. N1 is more, N2 is less. You count there. This is around 17 to 18 primary. Then it is 7 secondary. So, voltage now it is reduced. Voltage input is more, voltage output is less. Step down type of transformer. Such type of transformers we are using in your mobile charging units. 230 volts input, 5 volts output. There are so many applications. After introduction of transformer, electricity use changes, because history was started from DC supply. After introduction of such a static high efficiency device, now high voltage AC transmission, distribution, generation, utilization, all should be in AC popular along the country and worldwide. We are having two types of generation, two types of supply. Earlier history was started from DC supply, but distribution, there is no such device is not available in DC supply. Hence, such a static device, high efficiency, such a high efficiency device is not available in DC distribution. Hence, HVAC is popular, that is due to introduction of transformer. Its efficiency is 95 to 98, because power supply should reach after number of transformers getting the number 1 in generating station, number 2 in the receiving station, number 3 in substation, number 4 sub load centers, number 6 then distribution transformer. Number of times power should be transferred, hence this efficiency of equipment is very, very high, 98%, sir. Now, as per the construction, we are having two types of transformers. Again, core type transformer, it is already we discussed, it consists a magnetic core, it consists of two windings and laminated structure. This what we have seen. Number two, it is shell type transformer. Number two, shell type transformer. It has three limbs, core part 1, 2, 3. It has three vertical parts. Those are called limbs. On central limb, both windings are placed. Primary coil and secondary coil. Both windings are electrically separated. Both windings are placed on central limb, but both are electrically separated, but they may be linked by the magnetic circuit in both core type as well as shell type transformers. On central limb, both windings are placed as shown in figure. Now you see the different views of and transformer applications. So transformers are used in receiving station to transfer the power. The name itself calls power transformers. Now you can see there, this is 100 kVA distribution transformer which is used in substation to transfer 100 kVA. The voltage rating of the step down, usually we are using substations, it may be 66 kV or it may be 100 kVA, it may be air multiples of L1. Such type of transformers are used in substations. So this is also one of the example distribution type of transformers. Whole transformer core and winding is placed inside the tank. It is called as transformer tank, what you are seeing. These side plates are arranged for cooling. Sometimes these foils are referred, or sometimes it may be also called cooling tubes, because always transformers are loaded, continuous applications. Depending upon copper loss, heating effect is also developed inside the winding. This should not rise linearly, hence theta should be controlled. Cooling arrangement should be made inside the tank. These windings are immersed in transformer oil. There is a connection, this is insulator with lead point. Inside conductor are there. This main function, it connects external to internal connections. Sir, this is actually distribution type of transformer. You can view, these are available in your streets, or one is available at side of civil engineering department. You can see that L1 kV line input 440 volts output for three phase applications. Even small applications are also possible in TV or some electronic circuits. Now you can see there 220 volts AC input is there, 12 volts AC 1000 milliamperes. You can use for some electronics circuits reduction of voltage from 230 to 12 volts, or some electronics chips also required some DC supply. Later on, these are also used in rectifier units, conversion of AC to DC. Electronic circuits are also requires 230 to 5 volts or 12 volts. Now you can see this is one example of distribution transformer which is mounted on pole. From this pole, house connections are provided. Now see there, if question comes, discuss the types applications or types of transformers. Now which type is mainly useful? Depending upon application, the name is implemented. Example number one, distribution transformer. Distribution transformers are many. For example, 11 kV to 440, that is step down transformer. Power transformer, which are used to transmit the power, that is very high rating, 220 bar 110, 110 bar 66, 66 bar 33. All step down transformers are comes in power transformers, which are used to transfer the power. Current transformers and potential transformers, these are mainly used to collect the data of high rating and convert into very low level for measuring units. These are also required to measure the voltage of the line, current of the line, or maintenance. In the control room, we are having readings. We are having in substations, in receiving stations, in power generations, how much current is there in each line, how much potential is there across each generator, we have to measure. Hence, actually, they are very higher values, but meters requires less, hence, to convert the current higher level to lower level, to convert the potential higher level to lower level. Such transformers are used, that is current transformers and potential transformers. Furnace, what are the transformers are used for heating applications? Those are referred for furnace. Booster, to increase the voltage level, boosting the voltage level, it is called booster transformers. Rectifiers, some electronic circuits requires to convert the AC to DC. Sometimes DC applications is required for chip supply, for some microcontroller supply, some electronics purpose DC supply is required, hence AC to DC. Locomotive, it is more useful in electric trains. Electric trains requires DC supply because DC motors are used, but generally available is AC supply. Such a transformer conversion, high to low, it is called locomotive transformer. Mining, for digging of ores, some AC supply is required. Welding transformer, we require high voltage, required voltage and current can be produced from welding point. And converter transformer, high voltage testing, to test the insulation of high voltage, we are using high voltage, hence it is possible to convert 230 to 6.6 kV, 230 to 11 kV. Sir, thank you to one and all.